Hello.
How are you?
I'm very well, thank you.
What's your name?
I'm Vladimir Georgievsky.
Great name.
Thank you.
Where do you live?
Swansea.
Swansea?
Yes.
Okay. Are you married?
Yes, we have two sons.
Lovely. What are you going to do for us today?
I bought a trampoline for my kids, for my boys, in the back garden. I just started bouncing with them. And some of friends of us told me, I should do Britain's Got Talent.
So do you believe you can win this show?
If I wouldn't believe, I wouldn't be here.
Okay, well, that's good. Good luck.
Thank you very much.
Mr. Methane, I am a performing flatulist, and...
Just do it.
OK, certainly. Tonight, ladies and gentlemen, I'm going to put the art into fart. First of all, I just have to adopt the farting position. OK. You pick...
Who's that?
That was a good one.
Music Master! Thank you. Thank you.
I'm not using that microphone after him.
Thanks.
You are a disgusting creature.
Shall I go?
Sure, Mr. Methane blew it.
Thank you very much.
Lovely to see you again.
Nice to see you too.
Okay, remind everybody of your name.
My name is Gatis Kandis.
Do you know, this is the only comedian I've ever found funny.
Well, look, Gatis, welcome back. The stage is yours.
Good luck.
All of it?
Yes.
Okay. Thank you.
Go on, Candice.
So, you know, now is after a few cold days, it's getting warm outside. And I like the warm weather because it makes me warmer. That's my warm-up joke. When my chicken has a birthday, I don't tell him because he would not understand. So, I have another animal joke. Woof, 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 woof. That's a joke you can take home for your dog. Simon, have you got a dog?
Three.
Will you tell your dogs my joke?
Yeah? I was thinking about that when you said it.
Yeah, let me hear it.
Woof, 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 woof.
not sure they're gonna understand. Can you try it with my accent?
Woof, 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 woof.
Thank you for making me sound so sexy. So, does anybody like seeing couples kiss in public? No? No, well, I do. And every time I do, I always go up to them and I stare directly at them. And usually they stop. And then they ask me, do you mind? And I'm like, I don't mind. My name is Gatis Kandis. And in case you want to follow me, this is what I look like from behind. Thank you.
Oh, Gatis.
We are the Dots.
The Dots.
I'm Amanda, this is Rosie, and this is Kathy.
And so where do you normally perform?
All over the place.
I've never done it before.
Oh no, we said we weren't going to do that. We weren't going to say that. Basically, yesterday, one of our original Dots actually walked out, the creative differences. But Kathy has stepped in last minute.
Hang on.
She's learned the routine.
Don't just throw that away. What happened?
She's a bit difficult, should we say.
So you've never performed with them until today?
Oh.
No. Yeah. I am intrigued what you're going to do, so I'm going to let you take to the stage and go
Thank
for
you.
It.
Thank you.
You look happy.
I am. I'm quite delighted. Hello.
What's your name?
My name is Daliso. Daliso Chaponda.
That's an amazing name.
That's a Malawian name.
Malawian.
Yes. So I'm from Malawi, but I live in Manchester.
Why have you come on Britain's Got Talent?
I've come to make the people laugh. I am a comedian.
Oh, yes!
A comedy writer.
I would love the winner of Britain's Got Talent this year to be a comedian.
Oh, no pressure.
No pressure.
Who are you here with?
So I'm here just alone. My brother, no, he wanted to come, he's a doctor, and he was like, either I should save lives or come with you.
Were your parents disappointed that one of you was a comedian, one of you was a doctor?
They were absolutely horrified because I was studying computer programming, so uh-huh. I had a future. And I just decided, no, let me be a clown.
So we shall see.
Oh, darling, good luck.
Okay, excellent. Well, I'm at that age now. All my friends are getting married, and married people forget how horrible it is being single. They love to call me and complain about their coupley problems. Always get, you're so lucky being single. I get home, my wife just starts nagging, nag, nag, nag. I'm like, hey, I have to nag myself. I get home, I'm like, what time do I call this? Why don't I ever do the dishes? Sometimes I think I don't appreciate myself. I haven't always been a comedian. I did some weird jobs. I used to clean houses, and I'll admit I was tempted to steal. I didn't steal because the Bible says thou shalt not steal, but nowhere does it say thou shalt not swap. I took a stereo, left a Walkman. Took a plasma screen, left an Etch-a-Sketch. As I mentioned, I am from Africa. I moved here 10 years ago. And immediately I moved here, I heard a lot of British people talking about the financial crisis, the recession. I'm from Africa. What are you maniacs talking about? You call that a crisis? If that's a crisis, where is UNICEF? Where is Bono? I have not seen one Save the UK concert. You can tell me it's a financial crisis when there are planes flying over Birmingham tossing fish and chips out the window. It will be a financial crisis when there are ads on television saying this chav has to walk 5 miles a day to get a bottle of WKD Blue. And 100%, you have got a financial crisis when India starts opening call centers here. Can you imagine some poor guy in Mumbai calls his bank, ends up talking to a Brummy? Thank you so much, Brummy.
Best of luck.
Let's do it.
Oh my God. Oh my God. I'm like so nervous and so excited. It's like being on the X Factor all over again. Oh my God. I just love being a celebrity. When my agent said I was doing an advert for Iceland, I rushed out to get a woolly hat, a woolly coat, and a passport.
Hello, honeys. 100% definitely. You'll come to Amy Charles' salon in Essex. I love Essex. I work in Essex. I live in Essex. It's all about Essex. And I can spell Essex, I think. Oh, shut up. Oh, well, there's only one pricey. As you know my private life, you'll know I've just got married. Again. I organised it all. The church, the honeymoon, and the divorce lawyer. Hi, I'm Holly Willoughby.
In your face, Holly Willoughby.
And I present everything on ITV. And surprise, surprise, because tonight, Simon Cowell, I reunite you with the gorgeous Cheryl Cole. Hey. I'm totally, utterly excited to be here.
Oh my God.
Even to see you, Simon. My frenemy. Thank you!
Hi guys, welcome. You are?
My name is Hayashi. These two are my assistants. This is Ben.
Ben.
And this is Dan. He'll be serving as my eyes during this demonstration.
Right, nice to meet you. Okay, good luck.
Thank you. This samurai sword is an antique. A masterpiece of traditional craftsmanship. As you can see, it is extremely sharp and very dangerous. Please do not try anything like this at home.
I don't think too many people have got samurai swords, have they?
I have.
Ben, take a deep breath. I need you to focus. By volunteering for this, you're literally putting your life in danger. Let's get him strapped up. Go ahead. I also need someone to verify that I will be doing this blind. Come on. What's your name? Emma. Give her a big hand. Come on. Thank you. Take a look through this blindfold. Can you see anything? No? Through the other side? Emma? Please tie it as tightly as you can.
This is crazy.
Nice and tight, Emma.
He strapped the cucumber to his head.
Thank you very much. Please take a safe distance. Dad, are we ready? Let's go.
Really gonna do this.
Ben, don't move.
He's not gonna move.
And a man without fear.
Let's start with hello.
Hello. I am Viggo. I'm from Norway, but I live in the UK now.
Good.
Norway is very boring.
And what's your last name?
Venn. Yeah, like the diagram. You know?
Venn diagram, that's right.
Viggo, why are you here?
I'm here because I want to become a British comedian.
Okay, right, no more questions. Good luck.
Thank you, thank you. Simon's face is like this.
Look at Simon's face.
In Norway, that means you're doing really good. Oh.
Is there any more? Is there any more?
Come on, please.
Yeah.
honestly. Okay, any more?
You want more?
No. No.
I love this app so much!
To such a level that was just, it was killing me.
Oh, I thought you were going to do stand-up comedy.
Yeah, but it's a bit difficult with the language for me.
I have no idea what's going on right now, but it was really annoying, it was stupid, none of it was very good. Let's just go to the yes and no bit. Bruno.
A yes for me.
Oh, definitely yes.
Look, you know what? I like the music, but it is what it is, which is... the most stupid act we've had this year.
I think this feels very much Britain's Got Talent-y. So I'm going to say yes. We've got through to the next round.
Hi, what's your name, please?
My name's Lorraine Bowen.
Great. Do you have a normal job, Lorraine?
I do teach the piano to 12 students.
Obviously, you're singing for us. Are you singing one of your own songs?
Yes, it's called The Crumble Song.
The Crumble?
Yeah, Crumble, yeah, as in Sunday
Apple.
Afternoon pudding, yeah.
And Lorraine, can I ask you a question? Who are you here with?
I'm here with just my Casio organ. It's just, that's it.
Okay, good luck.
Hooray, let's go. Woo!
Everybody's good at cooking something. I'm good at cooking crumble. In fact, I've got one in the oven. Would you like some? A bit of custard, a bit of cream. It reminds you of your best dream. Anything. But if you don't tell me soon, I'll be off on my bike. I'll be off on my bike. Off on my bike. Off on my bike. Off on my bike. Everybody's good at cooking something, and I'm good. I've got one in the oven. Would you like some? Well, would you like some, right?
Yes! I'd like some.
Hey, let's just get this party really going now. My bingo wings are out there. I'll tell you what, let's do a mashup. Look, I've got my DJ headphones.
It doesn't matter what they think! Ladies and gentlemen, on behalf of the Palladium Theatre, I invite you to stand and welcome Her Majesty the Queen!
The Queen!
What?
That's why there's a throne.
That's right, Mr. Cowell. The boss is finally here. It's so good to see a member of the royal family sitting next to Simon. It's lovely to see you, Camilla. Yes. It is rare indeed for the sovereign to appear on such an insignificant occasion. But as I look down on you all, I am happy to patronize you. Queens have always patronized the arts, and the arts have relied upon the support of queens. And it is with regret, ladies and gentlemen, I have noted that recently Britain's Got Talent has suffered enormously. There have been far too many below-average variety acts, and I'm not referring to Alicia Dixon. I beg your pardon. I'm sure you all agree that plastic is the modern scourge on the face of this planet. Of all the men and women of these islands, no greater innovation has been made than by our judging panel, who have stored a great amount of plastic in their faces.
Oh, cutting!
That direction.
A for their services to the entertainment industry, and Dick, as well as David Williams, have been awarded OBEs. Simon, there is only one thing standing between you and the knighthood, and that's the golden buzzer. I have much pleasure, ladies and gentlemen, in declaring the search for talent in Great Britain officially open.
What's your name?
Hello, my name is Lee, and for obvious reasons, I'm also known as the Lost Voice Guy.
Okay, and how long have you lost your voice?
I just knew you were going to ask something that I hadn't thought about beforehand. So please excuse the awkward silence while I type out my answer. I've been speechless for 37 years.
Wow. Tell me why you decided to enter the show this year.
I think I entered Britain's Got Talent for the same reason everyone does. To meet Ant and Dick.
Yay! Yeah.
This is all going so well up until that point. The stage, Lee, is yours.
Hello, ladies and gentlemen. As you may be able to tell, I'm a struggling stand-up comedian who also struggles to stand up. To be honest, I'm not sure how good I am. I'll leave that for you to decide. But, just so you know, if you don't laugh at the disabled guy, you are going to hell. When I realized I'd never be able to talk again, I was speechless. I have lived in Newcastle all my life.
Yes!
But for some reason, I still haven't picked up the accent. I can see that some of you are trying to figure out where you know me from. Maybe it would help if I started saying phrases such as, "The next train to arrive on platform 4 is the 12:52 service to London King's Cross." And, from my time at the post office, please go to cashier number 8. I got the train here today. I always like to sit in those seats for disabled people. I was about halfway here when another disabled person got on and asked me to move. I didn't realize I'd be playing disabled top trumps when I got on, or I would have dressed more special. Needless to say, I didn't give up my seat. Who cares if he was both blind and deaf? I was there first. It was very awkward. He couldn't see that I was still there. And I couldn't tell him I wasn't moving because I can't speak. Before I leave you, I have one more thing to say. I hate that we have so many, politically, correct words to describe disabled people now. It's all special needs. Special schools, Special Olympics. I don't know what is so special about me. That is why it always alarms me when I hear about special forces going to war. You've been a fantastic audience. Goodbye.
Where are you from?
I'm from South Norfolk.
What's your day job, Ben?
I do this act.
Okay, I'm not going to ask what it is because we like surprises.
Lush.
Tell me why you've entered the show this year.
Well, my two little boys, they say, "Come on, Daddy, you've got to be on Britain's Got Talent."
So you've got sons, you've got kids?
I've got two children.
Okay, anything else?
Yeah, well, they did have a cat. Yeah.
Yeah. I won't go there. All right, Ben, good luck.
Thank you ever so much. Well, you see, I think my little stint now is all about me mishearing lyrics in music, see? I mean, it all started when I went to see The Lion King. Anybody see The Lion King? Yeah. Oh, I love The Lion King, but I must have misheard something, right? Because I thought the first song was about the Arsenal club football manager.
That's funny.
What I did then, right, I had a little think to myself. I thought, oh, maybe there's other songs, right, that you can hear that you think maybe they're singing something different, right? So I've amalgamated loads, and it's just for you. Hit it, Shirley!
You are the dancing queen, walking the sweet old
17. Oh,
no! When the clock strikes 12, we'll pull off that song.
Good evening.
What's your name?
My name's Christina Lennon.
Christina, why are you here?
I want to be the next Paul McKenna. I'm a comedy stage hypnotist.
Can you hypnotise someone to be a nice person? Is that possible?
Can you hypnotise somebody to stop being really annoying?
How long is this going to go on?
Not long. Okay. Well, look, why don't you just get on with the act?
I am actually only one half of the act. I'm the assistant.
Oh, okay. So you're not the person who's actually...
Hypnotising. No, I've got the master hypnotiser.
Okay.
Oh my god! This is Princess the Hypnodog. No way.
Hang on. You are telling me that that dog is a hypnotist?
I am indeed.
Okay, I've got to see this.
I need some volunteers from the audience. Let's have a look. Yep, you guys there, that row there. Do you want to come take a seat? Couple more seats, guys.
Us two.
Come on, you know you want to.
We're gonna get hypnotized by a dog. Come on, come on, come on. Oh, it's good.
It's good. On the count of five, you'll all be wide awake. As soon as I ask you to count, you'll find the number seven does not exist. On the count of five, wide awake. One, two, three, four, and wide awake. Wide awake. Do you want to take a seat back in your places? Do you want to count from 1 to 10 for me, please?
Yeah. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 8, 9, 10, 11.
Try.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 8, 9, 10, 11.
Okay. Give them a round of applause.
Dick, are you up? I'm going to be quiet about Dick.
8, 9, 10, 11.
Yeah, I don't know what was going on there. Alicia.
What the hell is going on? What have you done to our aunt and Dick?
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 8.
Well, she's amazing, and I think Paul McKenna has got a problem.
Did you believe it, Simon?
Well, I did at the end, yeah. I mean, I think if you're going to do this, I think you've got to get them to do more crazy things.
Yeah, this was more to show you what the dog can do.
Would you do it with to me?
Yes.
Up onto the stage.
Here we go.
I'd kneel down if I were you.
That's a first for a start.
Can you hypnotise someone to be a nice person? Want to be a nice person?
This is the clip they'll use when they know you finally lost your mind.
Well, nothing's happening.
I don't think you can hypnotise everyone.
Just a normal dog.
What happened?
Well, just like a dog with a huge tongue staring at me.
Right, we're going to take a vote, yes or no.
David, yes or no?
I'm intrigued and I'm going to say yes.
I am interested in seeing what else you could possibly do, so I am a little bit on the fence. But I think I'm going to say yes today.
I'm going to say yes. Simon? Simon?
Yes for me.
Thank you, thank you. Philip, did you bring anyone with you?
So, my friend Christy.
Did she work at Body Shop?
She did, but she's recently left.
Why?
Because she found a better job.
Found a better job!
Sorry!
Where?
She now works at Barrett's, so... Shoes!
I hope he's good after all of this.
OK, well, look, Philip, you've got roughly 2 minutes. Let's do it.
OK.
Natalie Cassidy. And today, we're going to be health working out. So everyone put your hands out in front of you, spread your legs, and do some squats. Lie down the baby on Martin Fowler's sofa. Isn't that right? Don Cotton would be proud, wouldn't she?
Ooh, it's so nice to be here on my new show. And today's guest is absolutely fantastic. You know what? I'm going to meet her. Hello. Oh, thanks for having me, Charlotte. Oh, I'm so nervous. Oh, come here. Oh. And then, oh, I was on Go Out of the Jungle recently. Oh, my God. I mean, I saw those ones, and I was like, whoa. And then I saw even more ones, and I was like, whoa. And then they tried to make me eat the ones, and I was like, whoa. And I was like, whoa. And I was being sick everywhere.
Oh, my goodness, have you seen the bacteria in here? It is awful. Isn't that right, Kim?
Oh, my love. Oh, that stinks. Dance, it's me, Louis Spence, dancing. Everyone like a duck. Come on, duck. Everyone, come on, duck. Everyone, duck. Duck. And down. Duck. And down. And Spence. Duck.
Oh. Oh. Oh.
like him. I like him a lot.
The brilliant thing about your act was that you had us laughing before you even did anything.
Oh, thanks, Amanda.
David!
You're like a butch version of me. You're a very, very funny guy. I'd like to see some more of you in the act as well. Because you are hysterically funny as you as well.
Are you sure you're not related to Stacey Solomon?
I wish I was. I've seen her from a distance and I was like, Stacey. But no.
I think you're really funny, lovable.
Do you need a wee?
No. I'm just really nervous. Sorry.
Simon?
It was like the world record for how many impersonations you can do in 2 minutes. I found it difficult to keep up with some of them. The ones that were great.
Oh, thanks.
But you are a naturally funny guy.
Oh, thanks.
Slightly bonkers. But I like that.
We're gonna take a vote. David, yes or no?
I'm gonna say yes.
It's a yes from me.
Simon?
And we have actually had some good impressionists on the show this year. So you have got some competition. But I am going to say... Yes.
That's four yeses. You're through for the next round.
Thank you so much. It's nice to meet you all. See you soon. Bye-bye.
Hello.
Hello.
Hi.
What's your name?
I'm Toju.
And how old are you?
40.
And are you married?
Is that a proposal? No, not married. Not to my knowledge.
And what is it that you're doing for us today?
Stand-up, impressions.
Brilliant.
We'll wish you all the best.
Yes.
Thank you. I love TV, man. Anybody here remember Blind Date?
Ladies and gentlemen.
It's Blind Date!
And here's your host,
Miss Zilla Black!
Oh. Oh. We've got three bonny lads behind that screen.
I didn't expect them to do Zilla. I really didn't.
And here's the gorgeous girl who's gonna meet him. Her name's Amanda. Come in, Amanda.
You know, I'd love to have seen. The screen goes back. She doesn't like the look of the guy. She makes it clear. Du-du-du-du-du-du-du. Pretty women, why do you always come to the club with a friend that doesn't look as cute as you? Yes. And guys, just as you're about to get the cute one's number, the friend comes along and messes it up completely. Yes, let me set the scene, Alicia. Hi, you're kind of cute. Oh, you're cute too. Here comes the friend. Who are you? Then they turn to their friend. Who is he? Then they turn back to you. Are you a nutter? You look like a nutter. You act like a nutter. Can you prove you're not a nutter? Exactly what I thought. You are a nutter. If I'm not getting a man, no one's getting a man. Total Recall, Predator, Commando, action films, I love them. Favorite action hero? Arnold Schwarzenegger. Yes. Because Schwarzenegger is always asking questions.
What the hell is going on? What did I do wrong?
And he's always trying to explain his drama to other people that don't care.
Some men just tried to kill me. I think they were spies or something. Harry from work, he was the boss. Blood on my shirt, blood on my hands, blood on my knife. He tried to take my life. Get down!
Thank you.
He's funny!
I like it.